All right, audio check, audio check, 1, 2, 3, audio check, audio check, 1, 2, 3, audio check, radio check, 1, 2, 3. All right, second audio check, audio checking, 1, 2, 3, we want a good stream, audio check, 1, 2, 3. All right, that sounds pretty smooth and clear. How are you all, you fans that have been checking us out live here on Twitch? Only be seen right here, right now. Chat lines are open for this amazing, unique channel called Rock TV Presents. And our show today, which is TNA Thursday Adventures, or Total Non-Stop Action. If you want those long, drawn-out campaigns and all that suspense and blah, 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 you're going to have to check out our other three shows we do during the week on our channel here at Rock TV Presents. I am, of course, your host with the most, Rage of Crixus, coming at you live here on Twitch, welcoming one and all to our awesome new theme for this next three-week trilogy, which is Pop Culture Icons. Characters branded and marketed so well from simple little video games that they became billion-dollar concepts around the world. With a little can-do attitude and some popular fan coasting, a lot of these games are now worth billions. This, of course, is the granddaddy of them all, the one that really created the word action. When you think of action, no one does it better than this guy. If you want story at that time, you were playing Nintendo and you were doing Super Mario Brothers. There's lots of campaign and, oh, we gotta save the princess and blah, blah, blah. Then Wario was the villain and blue, 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 blue. Now, Mario's got its own awesome thing, and don't get me wrong, Nintendo is amazing for that game. But Sega came in with this character here, Sonic the fucking Hedgehog. And this character now, you can look him on up, and he is now worth billions of dollars in video games, sequels, movies, merchandise, from a concept and a video game that came from someone's mind. You think about that. You think about that for a second. This was an idea in someone's head. And then they talked about it to some of their inner circle. And they said, hey, man, what do you think about this? And they're like, that sounds awesome. Let's go do that. And then they started small and they grew and they developed and they made their mistakes and they flourished. And now Sonic the Hedgehog, go ahead. How many people out there in the world, I don't care where you're from. You can be from Africa. You can be from Eastern Siberia. You could be from China, Canada, or frickin' down in Chile. There are people that know who Sonic the fucking Hedgehog is. He's as synonymous with breakfasts and morning cartoons than anything else, just like everybody else up there. That was an idea in someone's head. Everything you do in your life, everything you look around you, was originally an idea in someone's head. That's my deep thought for today. Let's get into the action. And just think about this show and where it might lead you one day to inspire yourself that an idea in your head might be the door to success for you and your family and friends. If you only believe in your idea, don't be amazed and don't be surprised if what you are trying to get actually happens. With dedication, commitment, hard work, learning from your mistakes, making mistakes, you can get where you want to go. Remember, Rome was not built in a day. They are the last descendants of the Trojan War. Remember the city of Troy? All those descendants that got wiped out? And only a few left, including the prince. And the prince went to Carthage, a neighboring city-state who just lost their king. And the queen felt sorry for them and brought them back and gave them shelter. And then, of course, fell in love with the prince. But the prince didn't want to stay in Carthage and be a king of that place. He wanted his own place with his own people. And those people would later become Rome. That's where all that idea comes from, an idea in someone's head. Inspire yourself. Be amazed at what you can do with your life. Let's go get into the action with the ultimate badass himself, Sonic the Hedgehog. He's supposed to be fighting, I was always taught and told, Dr. Robotnik and his horde of cybernetic and biologically enhanced bugs that he's been terrorizing for Sonic, right? He's trying to clean up the neighborhood and make a little money on the side, too. Don't get him wrong. He's got those rings. They give him money and stuff to do things, so I guess that's what he needs it for. So it's a fun concept. Let's get into Sonic the Hedgehog. Let's go find out why this game has endured the decades and been an inspiration to so many around the world. Come on, let's get into it. Welcome one and all to TNA Thursdays. Seems simple enough. Ooh, bonuses. So remember, the idea is to get through this as fast as possible. But do not forget, there is hidden shit everywhere. This is a video game. And I haven't played this game in a hot minute. I won't even kid you. It's been probably, what, 20 years? Maybe even more? I remember having a Sega Game Gear. Whoa! I remember having a Sega Game Gear. And this was the game I was on. I used to play this shit. Oh, see the big ring in the end? So if you get at least 50 rings, you'll get this big bonus. Big ring. And if you're able to time your jump properly, you can smash right into it and get extra. And that's the idea, right? You want to get as many coins as possible. Because you're a greedy hedgehog! Let's see, we go this way. What's over here? Here's stuff. What's this? Look at that. I just can't super feet. Oh, no! That was terrible. See what happened there? They got all kinds of hidden stuff. And you only get so many lives, right? This was an awesome quarter puncher back in the day. I wonder if we can go back the other way. Oh, that's what we do. That's right. We gotta shoot over that thing. Let's try that, guys. Let's get ourselves a little bit of ramp. I wonder if we can get there. We can bounce up the tree. Nope, can't do it. Skies and their secrets. I see if we're still getting those bips and glips. Are we still getting bips and glips there, fans? Whoa! Where am I going? I gotta get at least one ring. If you can get one ring, you get a chance if you screw up. So you gotta get at least one. Yeah, I'm not really sure why that happened. I got a ring. Oh, I see. Oh, I see, I see, I see. So I was going to a bonus area. Look at that. Whoa, where'd that guy come from? Look at this. Secret area. Oh, where's this guy going? Where's he going? Goddamn bugs! Give me a ring. Give me a ring.
Well, there's rings here.
We'll take these rings. Man, what is going on? Oh, let's do it. Oh, yeah.
Like it. Anyone know where I'm going?
Oh! How did I get back to the beginning? That's crazy. I've been in this level so long. When was the last time you folks picked up this game? I'm curious to see. Any chatters out there checking this out live? Wondering what the hell is going on here? Oh, what's that? An invisibility shield. I like that. Get a running start. That's when I needed that invincibility shield. No, not my rings.
I got a ring.
We're good. It's okay. I got 11 rings. I'm still alive. So yeah, they call him Eggman in this one. Dr. Eggman on the internet. And I was like, I thought he was, what's that? Well, it must have just dropped from the tree for me. How cool is that? Oh, I did it again. Wonder if I can hit it again. Well, I think he just gave me a bunch of rings. Look at that, hidden stuff. Oh, this looks like a boss fight.
Boom.
Am I not supposed to do that? Oh, don't worry, home slice. We gonna get you. No, get a ring. Yeah, it's been at least 20 to 25 years since I played this game. At least. Uh-oh. No! That's a long time. That's a long time. Okay. I got no rings. I gotta get rings. Oh, there's some rings right here. Perfect. Oh. Gone already. Okay, well, I got some rings. We can take this guy. Anyone remember how long and how many times you gotta hit this dude? Free shot! Shit! Damn it! Oh, you piece of shit. It's okay. I'll beat you with one ring, boy. Gotcha. With one ring. The one ring challenge accepted. Punk. That's right. You run like a scalded dog. I crush your machine. I'm Sonic the Hedgehog. The ultimate gangster. Looks like I gotta go find me some lives, eh? Holy smokes. This is crazy. Talk about action. Guess you can't hit those guys. I thought you could smush everybody. Shit. Whoop. Do it.
Push. Do it.
Yeah, it's been a hot minute. For sure. Oh, this is where I gotta do the pushing thing. Ugh. Boy, what's that all about, eh? Now what? Maybe I pushed it the wrong way, eh? That looks like exactly what I should have pushed it on top of the lever. I screwed it up. Not good. So do I kill myself? Oh, look at that. How nice of it to do that for me. Puzzles in Sonic the Hedgehog. Love it. I might as well just say I'm like playing this for a first time or something, because it literally is. Good stuff. Hey, I thought I was invincible. That's a shame. Damn it! Damn it! Boy, fall's a little slow, huh? Green bricks. Like they're made. Oh, I was stupid. Good stuff. I got one. I got one ring. Shit. She just called these the skin of my teeth challenge. Too funny. I hope this day is finding you well and you're finding yourself motivated and inspired to be the best you can be. We're having a whole lot of fun putting on this series. I know last week's finale of Warframe was absolutely awesome. If you get a chance and you want to see it, check it out. You could probably still do so. It's probably still going to be on the vault for one more day. And then it's going to be heading off to YouTube, where we keep all of our older stuff. Oh, God. Look at that. And no ring. Come on, buddy. Come on. Holy shit, look at all that fire. This is gonna be a problem. Oh, screwed it up. Game over? No! What does that mean? Means we get to do it again. That's okay. I'm going to go check out the chat lines. Like I said, we set aside a couple hours for this here little extravaganza. So you can always see how we challenge ourselves and then learn, right? This is like me playing it again for the first time. But this game has been around for over 30 years. It's amazing. I'm going to go check the chat lines there, fans. Give me a second. Okay, chat lines are open if you wanted to say what's up and say hi. I got a raid I'm trying to get going on too with Raid Connect, so we'll see what happens with all of that. Welcome one and all to our Total Nonstop Action Thursday's Adventures, where we're having a pop culture icons and the ones that helped influence this world with its mirth and merriment and comedy and action, which is what today is all about. So we just saw me bumble through this first little set of things while we were getting into this old 1991 classic. And I am, of course, your host with the most, Rage of Crixus. So, if you're curious about what we've been doing before, for the last 6 months or since we've been around, we've got, like I said, four different types of shows for all different types of people. And we can feature different kinds of animated series and stories based inside those universes, right? That's right. Right now, we've got Tuesday's Tales to Astonish, right? And we just started a brand new series there with the Savage Sword of Conan, which is a really awesome and super gory mature rated game, right? And now we're doing this little series here, which is fun for kids too, because we like doing that too. We've got racing games and wrestling storylines. We've done all these kinds of different themes for different types of people, and that's all on our YouTube vault. Just find the links on for our Reddit pages, for our social links, all on our Twitch account here. You can check it out and find out for yourself why people have been starting to grow and starting to catch and starting to really like this down-earth feeling and this homegrown, friend, fun little environment. So let's get into another gameplay. Come on. Let's see if we can beat our record. Let's go see. Oh! Good bonus, like that. Oh! Go back and get these up, see? Oh no, I missed it! Whoa! That was some height! Oh, I found some more rings! Look at that! You see that? Oh, I missed my big ring! Wait, I didn't. Can I get it? Oh! Almost got the big ring. Good stuff. I love this Sonic fella. Hey, what else you got, bubba? Ooh. Looks like we're zigging when we want to zag it. What's this? Oh, look at me, I got happy feet. I got happy feet. Holy shit! See that? That was bonkers. Now I'm invincible. Hey, why did I die? I thought I was invincible. What was that all about? Hidden stuff. That worked out pretty good. All right, let's do it. Yeah. Hope this show is bringing back a little nostalgic memories for you fans. Maybe it's got you wondering, hey, when was the last time I played this damn game? And maybe you'll want to pick up your old controller and your old system and maybe give it an old go too. And you're like, man, I remember when my life used to be good. I remember when I used to have all kinds of fun. It's good to remember how to have fun. Know what I mean? Important. Don't forget how to have fun. Life can get pretty tough as is, right? So, Jet! Gotta take care of your health. Gotta take care of yourself. No one is gonna take care of you more than you. So, be kind to yourself. Got that sucker! Look, he turned into a rabbit. Well, I guess he doesn't want me going that way. Holy shit! Get a ring! Get a ring! Got it. Something up here. Oh, I gotta get a checkpoint. Here we go. Oh, we're doing this guy again. Yeah, let's do it. We know how to beat this guy up. We know how to beat this guy up just fine. Shit. One ring challenge. One ring challenge complete. Skin of our teeth, just like the old goat likes to do. Even Sonic was like, yo, man, you want to, like, advance the game or something here? And now we free all those awesome little furry critters so they don't have to be turned into cybernetic monsters from Dr. Eggman. When you get thinking about the concept behind this guy, like an evil doctor who's turning animals, cute, cuddly animals, into friggin' monsters, man, horror show. Although I hear they're doing that now. Yeah, I've been reading some reports. They say they've been doing that kind of stuff. How cool is that? You got like birds and moths and stuff. They can control their flight patterns and stuff because of the chips they put in their brains and stuff. Real life. Yeah, science fiction is becoming science fact very, very quickly. Don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. All right, we know what to do here. This is simple enough. Uh-oh, that was dumb. Why did I do that? Not really sure why I did that. Oh, it's gonna make me do it all over again. Boo. Now you see why this game got so frustrating and why people played it forever, because they were constantly challenging themselves on how the hell do I do it, god damn it. And kids would lose their shit, and parents would lose their shit because they're listening to kids lose their shit. And everyone got mad. Damn it! My thumb slipped off the joystick. Shiza. Alright, we got this guy. Too bad there's no way to, like, get the hell up there. Not that I can see. Silly! Whoa. Spikes! Spikes! Goddamn bats. Yeah, this is pretty retro there, fans. When I was thinking up this thing, I was like, because this is the thing I said I was going to do, right? This is my style, right? We pick some of the coolest stories from like the last 30 years that have been motivating people forever. That's our whole concept of our show, right? Is just to get people freaking just loving it, right? And so TNA Thursdays is about grabbing these quick little one-shotters, giving them a little extra love because of nostalgia, I guess, eh? Help remind you about what ideas can do in the world. God damn it. Ideas can change the world, and it only takes one. It only takes one. I'm a firm believer in the power of one. Firm believer. That people can accomplish amazing, amazing things. If you just put mind and purpose together. So never give up on yourself. Never give up on...
Crap!
Hey, well, what's the point of collecting coins then? Because I had coins.
That's silly. I just got stopped there again. God damn it. That's no good.
All right, fans, we were just checking the chat lines there. Looks like we got a raid going on from Raid Connect. Hello, everyone that's checking us out today. If you're looking at this old 1991 game from Sega, and you're going, what the deuce is this all about? Who would stream this? I'll explain. TNA Thursdays is one of our unique channels on Rock TV Presents, and it allows us to showcase three little unique games based on a certain theme, just for a quick little trilogy, right? 2 to 3 hours each episode, you get to relive a fantasy, relive a storyline from a multiverse from decades ago. Some of them are very unique, some of them no one has ever seen. And so this show is about getting people into learning about all that stuff. So let's get into more of the action. Today is about Sega and Sonic. So my audio is getting a little ippy and blippy, so I'm just going to unplug for a little bit here, let it reset, and we'll get back to action. I got a bonus. So you get a bonus when you get your hoops, right? When you get your hoops. See, the idea is to get as many as possible, right? Not play like the bumbling idiot. And you only get so long in the bonus world. All right. We'll be right back. This is crazy. You folks are starting to remember how challenging this game was, right? Just going absolutely bonkers. That's why this channel exists, man. I mean, how can you not pay a little extra homage and respect to the greats of the old, right? And that's why this trilogy we're doing is our pop culture trilogy. Some of the best popular culture parts branded and marketed items ever done that have shaped the ideas and the culture of our absolute world. All our societies have developed because of the concept developed in these purely amazing universes. These stories, these amazing stories. That is why this channel exists. Oh, I missed my coin. Can I come back and get it? No, I can't. Gotta keep an eye on my ring count. So if you think Sonic the Hedgehog is awesome, wait till next week. Next week, we're doing Asterix and Obelix from the XXL2. Oh my God, that is gonna be a wild ride, man. If you think Sonic is big, Asterix and Obelisk is also big. And in the third episode of this trilogy, we're doing the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Shredder's Revenge. I mean, how awesome of a trilogy is this gonna be? Some of the best and most powerfully branded items and icons ever are gonna get their own little show here on Rock TV Presents. That's what we do on Thursdays. It's all action-based, right? All action-based, things that we want to see happening on action. And we save all our drama and stuff for those, like, Tuesday's Tales to Astonish. And we got Epic Saturdays. And then we got Sunday Funny Choose Your Own Adventures. They all have their own unique styles and themes. And their own shows, which makes them awesome. Whoa! I'm, like, really moving. I got to get away from that bouncer, though. All right, we got to wait for that. Oh, look at that. Avoided those things. Oh, look at that. No, I fell. There we go. Okay, so I should get a big ring now. So I got to get that big ring. If I can just get there without dying. Shit. Well, there goes my invincibility. Oh, look at that. Did you see that? Good haul. No more rings. Good stuff. Is it 100 rings you get your bonus? I think it's 100 rings. Oh, this is the boss fight. Shit. No rings. Just the boss. I'm in your big honking, chonking bully. You gotta save all my rings this time. I don't want to be a poor man. Sonic wants his money. Damn it! It's okay. We can do the one ring challenge. Two rings! Ha 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 ha! How much fun is that? Yeah, the last trilogy. Like I said, we'd like to do three little unique games, right? Unless the game is so amazing that you've got to just do three episodes of all of it, right? Which is what the last one was, because we did a Warframe trilogy. So you got to get real down and dirty with the Warframe universe. And that third episode is still actually on Twitch for its last day. And then it's heading off to the YouTube vault where we've got all of our old stuff. We've been doing all kinds of stories for the last 6 months now. And we've got enough content to do this for years. We can't wait to showcase some of these amazing universes in a nice animated series in the only way that Rage of Crixus and Rock Entertainment Media can do. We're going to have us some fun. Oh, you bugger. And we got all kinds of stuff, right? We got mature rated stories like Savage Sword of Conan, which is going right now on Tuesday's Tales to Astonish. And then we're going to do little soft features like this too, right? We did a fighting game one trilogy. Man, this guy, that was really good. But again, you know, PG-13, we don't always do blood and guts. Not always.
Oh, I got it.
No, I lost my ring. No.
Shields up.
What? What was that? I don't even know what that was. Why am I having so much trouble with this? This is ridiculous.
Holy smoly. Okay.
Can we load a game? What load? Oh, I don't have any game to load. Fumbling and stumbling through this until we figure it out. I hope this day is finding you well, though, fans. It's really fun seeing our fan count growing every month. The people are just catching on to the cool times. Whoa, did you know there was one of those things there? Me neither. Learn something new.
Look at that. So now I can smash into anything and everything dies.
In fact, I think you get the bonus count for doing that. All right, shields down.
Holy smokes.
Okay, we got 55 coins.
Whoop! Got him. Oh, there's another ring in there. What?
Okay, this is where we're gonna get our big ring.
Come on, baby. Got it.
Good haul. Look at that. Good stuff. Look at us learning things and having fun again.
Oop.
This is fun and cute and all. Don't get me wrong, it's fun. But that Savage Sword of Conan I filmed on Tuesday.
Man, that game was gory, but man, was it fun.
It was so much fun. It's got like over 40 views, too. That's one of our highest ones we've had in a while.
Oh, that's all the time we get. Crap.
This has been a fun show. This TNA Thursdays is a real special place in our heart because you don't have to get into all the drama and all the story. You can just go and have some damn old fun.
Wait, I want to do that guy. I want to do that guy. Oh, I want to do that.
No.
Shit.
Like, when I saw this was on the arcade, I was like, get out of town, Sonic. I mean, like, how did they get the rights from that? I thought Sega would control all that with their Game Gear and their Genesis and stuff.
I guess so. Fine by me.
I like Sonic. I was a big avid fan of this when I was just a young lad. Now I'm not a young lad. I would like to know how to get to that. Whoa, what's that? I want to get to that extra man. Makes me think there's gotta be a bouncy something around here. Gonna waste my invincibility.
Buggers. Oh!
What was that? That was terrible. How did that happen?
Right. Yes, yes, yes!
Good times.
Good times.
Good stuff. Back when video games were just that. Video games, they were no longer money-making designs and machines, right? Like they are nowadays.
Damn you! Wait! Oh!
He was coming back. Hey, looks like I got an extra man.
There's something in the trees. Wait. There you are. I see you. Look at that. Maybe I'll get an extra chance here. Eh? And shields. Invincibility and shields. What? Now, just shields. Check. Sonic the Hedgehog.
Man, it was fun hitting the Reddit pages with this thing. And the socials got to see the ads I've been putting on it too, and they're like, dude, what is this doing on? I'm like, dude, you're gonna love it.
Where are we going?
Did we literally just go right back? That's hilarious.
What's this mean? Can you go here?
What's this?
What's this? Secrets! Look at that.
Secrets! I like secrets. I like secrets very much.
Oh, more secrets! Anyone know what I just did? Whoa. Oh, I was right on the ledge. I wanted that too, didn't I? Secrets! There's an extra man!
I need an extra man, too. Yeah, no problem. We got that part figured out already. How about we learn how to stop bumbling and get through this whole system? I hate these guys so much.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. He dive-bombed me? And now I've got no coins. Shit!
Man. You guys remember being as frustrated as this is?
I remember.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I remember how frustrating this game got. I remember real good.
Too funny. What the deuce? Did you know it did that?
I totally forgot.
No!
Holy shit.
Okay, so I gotta take it real slow here, right?
Because it's glitching and stuff.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, I don't know what the deal with those bats are, but...
for the spikes.
Hey, did you know he could duck? I didn't know he could duck. All I did was pull down on the joystick and he ducked. That's crazy. It's actually really cute. Good. How about we advance past this part? I knew he could push.
Boo, boo, boo.
Good, 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 good. Yeah, we got this part down, Pat. We got no problem with this part. Now I gotta jump on the spikes and get across. I'm in virgin territory! Look at me, winning. Learning from my mistakes. Growing, evolving, and becoming stronger. Oh, hells to the yeah. Look at that, I'll get all those extra points. Even it was like, holy shit, buddy, it took you a while, eh? Good for you. Go, Team Attitude. Rock TV presents Motivation! Oh, what? Give me a ring, give me a ring! Okay, as long as I have one ring of power, I can survive! What'd you get out of here, bug? Oh wait, I think I made it here before. I don't think I made it farther than that. Boop! Oh, oh. What the deuce? What? Hey, all of that is bad. All of it. The lava is coming for me! Dude, what? Shit! The one ring grab! Oh, what was that? I got this guy! He's just a dumb old seal anyway. Where are we going, Bubba?
Well, I guess we're going this way. Look at that.
Okay, let's get to pushing. Well, that seems like a whole lot of fun.
Got a ring. One ring of power. I have two rings of power.
Boy, they don't make it easy, do they?
Up. Rings.
Good stuff, good stuff.
This goddamn guy. Come down on his head! Crush him! We smash him to smithereens.
Dude, where the fuck are we?
Hmm. Smash him with my hedgehog spikes. We call him Sonic the Barbarian.
No, that's for Tuesday, silly.
Different character and voice.
God damn it! I crush you all!
Oh, cool. Look at that. Chronic the Builder.
Right.
So I got rings again. That's a good thing.
A bunch of glowing lava. Not so good. Oh, look at that. Invincibility. Boom, boom, boom.
Wait.
Where did I go? What happened? Does anybody know what just happened? So I'm kind of glad I recorded that, because I really want to know what happened.
So I kind of like just disappeared from the map. I'm not really sure what that is.
I didn't even know that could happen. You guys ever see that before?
That is crazy. Wow, maybe they got some of the original 1991 glitches in here too, eh? That'd be kind of cool.
What? Get out of town. Oh. God damn it!
I don't like any of that. Now I got no rings.
What am I supposed to do?
I guess I'll go get this shield. So that'll help me a little bit, right? Right?
Sure. Look at that. Rings.
Okay. I'm still alive. I'm still in this fight. I'm Sonic. Too tough to quit. McGee. I don't like this guy.
Got him.
Okay, so this is where I made it last time. So what happens if I go this way?
Look at that. Damn it.
I got coins. I'm still in this.
Still in it. Just gotta be careful. Only got one life left. Whoop! Damn it! Still got coins.
Let's see if we can maximize our points, eh?
Because it seems to really like doing that.
And that's groovy to me.
Damn it!
All right, I'm invincible. Fuck this shit. Hey, what happened to my invincibility? What's that all about? You have got to be kidding me.
Holy tololy.
It did say invincible, didn't it? Okay, well, let's see what we did for leaderboards here. I don't know what any of those are. Those must be some other homies I got rocking and rolling. Let's see. 662550. Looks like a lot of people do that. Buck.
Oh, these are my buddies.
Looks like I'm hurting.
No, I'm doing pretty good. I gotta get up there, though. No way my buddies could beat me in this. Thank you one and all for having your Twitch notifications on live so you can catch this weird, goofy little thing. Like I said, this is our first episode of our Pop Culture Icon Trilogy. And so this week is about Sonic the Hedgehog, kind of remembering and reminiscing about the times, learning a little bit about the business too, that how this cultural icon has influenced so much from merchandise to games to movies to animated series, just like this one. And next week we're going to get into the Asterix and Obelisk storyline from the XXL2 from the old Atari game. Let me tell you something, that brings back good memories too. Because I've been again doing all these games and part of all this culture since the very beginning. I'm an old man myself, just having a fun time showcasing all these cool series for all the fans of Rock TV Presents. So the audio bips and glips from time to time. We are apologizing for that. There's not much we can do about it at the time. These are just live streams. It happens. And so I do monitor it, just like I monitor my chat boards. So note that if it is bipping and glipping, it ain't going to stick around for long. And I'm going to unplug my mic, plug it back in, and things seem to seam up again. So I just keep an eye on it until my hardware upgrades, right? Until I can start making money doing this kind of thing. This is kind of what we got for now. So we do what we have. Besides, the pizzazz and the personality of Rage of Crixus is what makes this show so charismatic and fun. So what say we get back into trying to figure out how to goddamn beat our scores? Come on! Let's get into this, Sonic! Alright, you guys remember where we had a lot of this hidden stuff? Let's see if we can figure out how to get more of them damn lives, eh? Whoa, what was that? Hidden in the treetops. I'm gonna keep my eye on these treetops. Maybe I shouldn't be blasting through this. I mean, this, I don't really want to do a time challenge. I want to figure stuff out. Get in there. Whoa! Look at that. I almost fell to my death. Ooh! I'll be back up nice with the win. Damn it. Look at this. Who doesn't love that? Holy shit. $119 rings. Are you kidding? Ridiculous. Robotnik's down there. I got my ring! Good stuff. Look at that. 4 lives. So you see, the better you play, the more brains you use, the more lives you get. As you can see, you can plow through the lives pretty damn quick. Stay on these pogo balls. No. Shit. Because once you reach the goal line, it's over. You're out of time. But you gotta keep spinning it around. We'll be right back.
See, it usually does that. It'll give you a chance to right your wrong and maybe get it. But you gotta be quick.
Huh?
Gotta love video games. They inspired the businesses that we all love today. Some of the greatest stories, you know, coming out of the world. Bungie and Epic Games. You think about how awesome some of these companies are. Just the stuff coming out of Sony even. Like Horizon Down. Like, there's just so many amazing stories out there. And we at Rock TV Presents plan on showcasing as many of these stories as we can humanly possibly can. Trying to rob me of me coins and me rings. I don't think so. Ooh, speed booster. Mega Rocket Man. Holy shit. Time to go Sonic. Whoa, I gotta get the checkpoint. Maybe I want to go back that way. Maybe I can get away from all those damn spikes. Let's try. No, it's not going to let me. That sucks. There's something in the tree. Oh, look at that. That's going to come in handy, so let's give him a running start. We'll blast right past all that shit. It's okay. We just needed to get through that. Holy shit! Just screw it right up. We were doing so good, too. Damn it. Frustrating. Boom! Oh, there's secret stuff up there. This is awesome. Whoop! Look at that. Oh, secret stuff. Oh, look at this. More coins. How cool is that? What? Look at that goddamn guy. What? Oh my god. That is absolutely terrible. Hold on, fans. Looks like we're getting a chatter. Just wanted to say hi to the good old there Schlifty, saying hi and what's up. Remember, that is the whole reason why we do this show here on Twitch. It's because it makes it fan interactive. You can get involved, say what's up, see what you're doing, blah, blah, blah. I mean, what other network in the freaking real world will allow you to do something like that? I don't know any. In fact, I love having fans join the game, if it's possible, right? God, this is so frustrating. So the key thing to remember is even though you're getting your butt kicked and you're getting blasted and stuff like that, remember, as long as you can get one damn coin, you can still finish it. And that's the whole point. I mean, as you get really, really good with your reflexes, you can obviously commit more of your attention span to... get more of your attention span focused on your time trials and your speed trials and all that stuff. But if you're trying to learn about the game and all the hidden stuff, which there clearly is, right? Just look what we're doing here. Hidden stuff.
You gotta take the time, you gotta go backwards, you gotta see what's going on. All that stuff, right? So, explore the game. Love the game. The creators loved building it, and they want you to love it too. So don't be shy. Explore the world. That's why it was created, so you could fall in love with it, just like they did making it, right? Boom! This is why this whole channel exists, right? Because it's about showcasing a little extra love to the damn games that help create our world that exists today. Oh, boss fight. Okay, we know how to get this guy. We know how to get this guy. Now go to town! Wait for the boulders. Boom. Gotta be quick. Boop. Got him. Full rings. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. I mean, who doesn't want to remember days when they were a little bit better, eh? A little bit easier on life? It seems as you get older and you go through the education system and, boy, everyone loves each other when you get into kindergarten, you know? And by the time you're done high school, you know all about hate, bigotry, you know about racism, you know about all the negative things of our world, and you forget about all the cool things about being alive and just loving one another because, hey, you like Sonic? Hey, I like Sonic too. You want to be friends? Yeah, I'd love to be friends, you know? So we gotta remember about the cool things that used to just bring us together, right? It's about, well, you like this, I like this. Yeah, it's cool. You don't like this? Oh, that's too bad. I like it, and this is why. That's why this whole channel exists, is to teach people how to communicate to one another again, like they seem to have forgotten. You can still have civil conversations. You can still talk to people and strangers on the street without having to be afraid of what someone's going to say. You know what I mean? You don't have to be living a world of fear. That's a terrible way to live. Terrible way to live! Man, I talk to everybody. I'm out in the world every single day, meeting and greeting and doing all kinds of stuff. And I talk to everybody. I tell you. That is the world I want to live in, a world where we can talk to one another and we can be civil to one another and we don't have to be afraid of what's going to happen next, you know? I don't want to live in that world, so I don't live in that world. Oh, Vampiro trying to come get me. Screw him. Ho, ho, ho! Did you see me duck at, like, the exact moment I needed to? Like, right before the spikes and right before Vampiro was coming to get me. Crazy. Hey, why was I pulling the whole fucking Chuck Norris thing on the side there, gagabaggy? That was ridiculous. What was that all about? And I lost my shields for my efforts. Boo. That's weird. It's fun to have chatters checking this out, seeing out why we're doing shows like this. I mean, when is Sonic the Hedgehog, like this version of the game, even been relevant to popular culture? Well, it was very relevant for a long time. And honestly, like I said, Sonic the Hedgehog is friggin' huge. Asterix and Obelix, which we're doing next week, is going to be massive. And on our third part of the trilogy, right? Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Shredder's Revenge. Who doesn't remember pumping quarters into that old sucker? I remember. I remember stealing money out of my dad's wallet so I could go play it in the arcade. Ha ha ha! So we're going to get into this fun little old school retro trilogy, and we're going to just remember some of the fun we had. Cool. Where? Whoa, where'd this guy come from? And we'll save all the drama and the cool cinematics and the other events for the other days of the week. Like, we even just did on Saturday our one-shot event. It's our WWE 2K event. So if you like wrestling events, we curated our own special show for WWE 2K. We did an event called Rebellion, and that's in our Twitch file right now. And that will wind up going on our YouTube vault probably next week.
And that's a once a month wrestling event we do just for fans and how to have fun. And let me tell you, if you like wrestling, you're going to want to check that out. It's got some really good stuff. And now that we've actually been practicing, we've been learning a bunch of the secret moves. And now next month's pay-per-view is going to be epic. We're talking flaming tables. We're talking backstreet brawls. We're talking old school rivalries. We're going to have the biggest roster of created characters anyone has ever seen. I promise you that. Gonna be sick. Who doesn't love pop culture? Look at all this fun. Bet you're gonna wanna pick up your controller when we get done this, and you're gonna wanna play it yourself. Just to see if you can top my scores. In fact, I dare any of my followers and fans right now to do that. Pull up your old Sega one, because I'm recording this show, right? So you can watch it at your heart's content when we're done. And then you comment on one of my social links or something, and you tell me how you did. See if you can beat my scores. See if you can beat this old pro, because I'm not done yet. That'll be chat friendly and fun, eh? Come on, let's get a challenge among friends and fans. Ah, we're done. Ha ha ha. Good stuff. Just chatting with our fan there, friends. And remembering the good old nostalgic days. Like I said, when we used to just... I actually remember, like I said, I used to have this on a Game Gear when I was like 18. And I had this on a Game Gear, and it was like one of my favorite games I had on it. And that's like old. And I remember getting so mad at this goddamn game. I accidentally pushed too hard on my console, and I cracked the screen. And I was like, you gotta be kidding me. So, yeah, that's when I learned about rage, road rage, gamer rage, and all that other shit. So needless to say, I don't do any of that stuff anymore. It taking me back all the way to this? Man, where? Oh, this is the next stage. That's right. I've just done this level so many goddamn times that it just feels like, wasn't I just here? Yeah, I was. I just keep dying. No! Get a ring. I got a ring. Yeah, I remember getting frustrated at this game. It is so much fun. So much fun. Oh, yeah. Good times. Just getting stabbed. What? Late. Oh, God damn it. Give me a ring. No. Shit. I'm in trouble. Shit.
Oh my god.
It's so cool that he can duck. I completely forgot. I remember now that he could duck, and there was instances for it, too.
Tracing point! God damn it!
Now I got no rings of power. I gotta get rings of power!
God damn it!
Point of this? And why is this even here? Holy shit! Ring of power! Yeah, you got a couple seconds of invulnerability, so use it wisely. Like, what is this guy doing? Who? Crap. Good stuff. I'll take it. Gotta get past this. Gotta take it easy. Come on. Go, Sonic, go, go, go. I like his red shoes. Do you think they are Converse All-Stars? Probably, eh? Those were popular back in the 90s. I remember I was actually in grade 7 in this rural country town where I was going to school. And I didn't have a lot of money, but my parents knew I needed shoes. So remember, this is a redneck country town. Cowboy boots and hats and all that bullshit, right? And my dad got me some bright orange Converse All-Star high tops to wear to this country bumpkin redneck school in grade 7. You can imagine the heckling and toxic behavior that I had to put up with for as long as I had them shoes. But I had no choice. Like, I'm a poor kid, right? I got no goddamn shoes. So, man, the fun I had. There, now you know a little bit about me. People's like, well, how come you don't show your face on camera? Actually, I follow some guys on Twitter, and they are adamant that having a face cam is the best way to do your streams. And I'm like, why? Do you see what people do to celebrities with faces? Like, no thanks. I'll stick to just my voice, and I'm good. I get by just fine. Shit! I can't get past this shit. Damn it! Wait, I got invincibility. What am I doing? Okay, invincibility's gone. Time to start getting smart. Well, holy shit! Did I just finish that? No way! No way! That's crazy! That's so cool. We got like 3 people watching this old school crap right now. That's awesome. And Schlifty's just chatting away, man. He's living the old dreams. Man, you got to put in the comments. It's like, how old were you when you first played this game? I was 18 years old, which I'm not going to tell you how old I was. Let's just say it was decades ago. We'll just leave it at that. Not that I give a shit, because age is just a number to me, and I'm probably like the youngest looking person my age, and I've got really good shape too. I didn't used to be. A year ago, I used to be in pretty bad shape. I wasn't taking care of my health, but I realized that, you know, my kids, they're going to need their dad's help, because life can be damn tough, and they're not, let's be honest, they're not quite ready for the challenge that this world does. So I'm staying healthy long so I can stay alive long enough to give them a hand, just in case. Because I remember when I was young and growing up, I couldn't really rely on my parents or anybody for help. So I really had to really count on myself. And I had friends who helped me out along the way, and you know, I had good family that helped me out along the way too. It's tough. It's tough out there, man. So I want to be able to help my kids if they need it, right? Being a good parent means you never stop loving your children and you want to take care of them. And so these games and stuff like that is a way for us to hopefully develop an income stream upon which we can help myself and, of course, help them. I got no rings! What am I doing here? I'm crazy! Hey, I want to go that way. Shit, it's not going to let me. Okay, well, I guess we're going to go on the floating rock and get ourselves some rings. Good times! Simple enough of a concept, right? I mean, they make it easy enough for a child to play. But as you get along, of course, in this game, you're going to realize it takes a lot more than just a child's brains and reflexes to do this. You got to start developing some real life skills. Ooh! Look at that. Good stuff. Spikes everywhere. Like, who designed this place? Oop! No, no, no! Look at that. I got super squished. But at least I'm here. Act 3. And I still got 2 lives. It'd be nice if I could find out where they got more hidden. Oh, that's good. Dr. Eggman and his goddamn minions.
Rings. Good, good. From the Horde.
Gotta admit, guy's pretty connected though, right?
Check! Go! You're invincible! Go, go, go!
Yeah, don't even bother fucking around.
Go, go, go.
Okay, so we want to learn from our mistakes. We want to go over here. How do we get over there? What's with this guy over here anyway? Funny thing is I actually do remember there being... Okay, well, why didn't my shield kill him? That's weird. Because there are secret rooms, like, all over the place. You gotta know where they are in order to get them. It's weird. Like I said, this is a game, and they got real clever. Gotta love those Japanese, man. They are smart, smart people. I got a lot of respect for Japanese culture, let me tell you what. Well, look at all the fun we're having.
Okay. Oop. And then you knock me back down into the goddamn room!
Right. So none of that was good.
What to do?
Shut up, bitch.
Man. I'm an old man just a struggling through this child's game from 1991.
That's right, this isn't none of that. This is none of the gimmicks and bullshit and all that other stuff. No, this is the original badass himself. Right, the thug who started it all. It's funny, when I was first teasing I was going to do this show on TikTok, I was able to put in Tupac's Thug Life to it, and it was just sick. Like, it was actually hilarious. And it worked out so well, too. Yeah, so let's drop down this time. So what's, like, over here? Well, I don't get any of that at all. Or did I just figure something out? Or maybe not.
Oh.
Got that bug!
Shit.
Nope. There's gotta be a way over there.
I just don't know what it is.
Nope. Well, I don't know. I don't see anything.
Got no rings. Ring of power! Good stuff.
Well, it's supposed to be total non-stop action, but I'm like, not dang bringing it. Oh, see, I went a different way this time.
Oh! Oh, no, 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 no. What the fuck is going on? Whoa!
What? Where are we?
God damn it!
Well, I got 3 rings.
Oh, no.
Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. I'm on my last life. I can't be screwing this shit up.
Hup, boom.
Are there spikes coming out of both sides? No, just the one. Okay.
Checkpoint!
That's exactly what we wanted to see. Not that it matters. I gotta find a life.
3 minutes. Holy shit. It's terrible. Oh, boom. I guess we want to get this going, eh? Damn it!
Damn it!
Got the one ring. I got the rings. We're not.
God damn it!
Got one ring. Oh, did you know that? If you look up, you can actually see what's up. I didn't know that. Whoa, where's with all the bats? Boom. Look at that. Look up, look down. That's cool.
God damn it!
I didn't know that was there. I gotta look up more. Up. How nice of them to put the spikes in alternating piles. Boom.
God damn it!
Man, where the shit? This is a long level. Holy shit.
God damn it!
Like toe jamming it on the end. Ah! Converse All-Stars weren't exactly known for their grippiness when it came to these types of environments. Great for basketball courts. I don't know about here. Oh shit. Oh shit! Got it. I saw flames. No, whoa! Dead. I'm dead. Oh, and I did so good too. Man, that was my best I've done yet. Look at that! It's gonna let me resume! What was that all about? I must have done well enough. Schlifty was wondering if I ever actually finished this game. And I'll be completely honest with you, I don't think I ever did. After I busted my Game Gear, I actually don't remember ever playing Sonic again. So, like I said, it's been a few decades since I've played this game. But now I have this game, right? It was a game I got free on... Yeah, I got it free. It was one of those free games they gave away on Xbox Game Pass or some shit. And I wound up picking it up. And I was like, okay, we're going to make a show out of this. We're going to see all the bumbles and stumbles of this goof as he tries to remember his childhood in this game and why he got so damn frustrated with it. Whoa! Look at all that shit. No! Okay, I'm in it. I'm so scared.
Hup. Oh, whoa.
Hup. Boom. Oh, big boomba clot, man. Oh, brother. Hey, did I find my way over here? Look, oh, no, I did this before. That's no big secret. There's something going on here, though, for sure. I could feel it. See, I was trying to jump on his goddamn head with my shield, and it didn't let me do that. So that really irks the shit out of me. I don't even need to go up there. I don't even know why I'm doing this. I'm being dumb. Something going on. There is something I'm missing.
What am I missing?
I don't know what. Sonic the Hedgehog. Remember seeing those goofy graphics on t-shirts? I remember seeing that in Spencer's of Sonic the Cramp or Chronic the Hedgehog. Ha ha! When they started incorporating Sonic the Hedgehog into weed culture. Hilarious, man. Too funny. Got that piece of shit. That spiky ass bastard. Herp. Hey, why did it double bounce me in that? No. Stupid. I'm dumb. Ring of Power. Ooh, double smash. Whoop. Good stuff. God damn it. Whoop. Holy shit. Ring of Power. Okay, so we know we can't sucker punch that booger, so we're not gonna bother. Not gonna bother. There's gotta be a way. See, there's rings over there. I wonder how you do it. I don't know. Don't know. I hope this day is finding you well, though, on this awesome Thursday. It's nice and sunny up here in Calgary. Always a good time. Stampede is finally done, that worldwide cowboy event that I really don't give a shit about. I'm a child of this world, and so as such, I have adopted customs and cultures from everywhere I go to. I am in love with the people of this planet because they are capable of amazing things. They're also capable of terrible things, but I try not to focus on that stuff. Humans can do amazing things if they but seek it out. This goddamn bug. I was trying to get him. Need a headshot. But it was not to be. Alright. We'll just grimace across these floating ramps. Because it's fun. Smash this guy. Checkpoint. I like that. Like that a whole bunch. Man, there is this awesome courtyard that I live in this apartment complex. It's absolutely phenomenal. Every day I see rabbits and squirrels and birds. It's awesome. Such good times. But right now, there is a kid out there losing his effing mind. And it's absolutely hilarious to listen to. What the fuck is going on? Oh, I did it! Look at that! New checkpoint. No! Goddamn spikes. No, I think we made it not much farther than here, I tell you. That's right, because this is where the spike... Hey! What was that? Now I got no goddamn rings. Rings! And someone to take them from me. How cool is that? Hey, I was fucking smoking that guy.
Oh, I hate him so much!
This blue-haired little freak. Amazing that one little idea and one little brand icon could change the world. If you think Sonic the Hedgehog didn't actually change people's minds, inspire, and make people happy for generations, then you are wrong. And things that can create happiness, well, happy people create amazing things. So you think happiness doesn't work? You think being happy doesn't work? I say you're wrong. The only thing that really ever beats evil is love. It's the only thing that's ever beaten evil is love. It's the only thing that's ever going to be. It doesn't always win. Doesn't always win. But it's the only thing that can do it. You know what I mean? So you got to learn to love yourself and love your what you do and love the world. And you can change everything. You can change it all. No! Shit! One ring again. One ring of power. Oh, did it take me back? Oh my God. We literally are back. That's crazy. These dungeon levels, what? Too funny. Doing the Alpha Squad, one ring, one ring. Alpha Squad! Damn it, ye.
Yeah, it dropped me right back down to the beginning.
Boo.
Okay, well, I don't want part of any of that shit. None. I don't want any part of that. Hoop.
Hoop. You goddamn bastard!
Oh, no! I can't make that jump, and now I got no rings!
What to do? That's some rumbling, bumbling, stumbling, old man.
Oh, I'm such a failure. Oh, God. Oh, shit. See what I mean? Putting on a show, getting distracted, and you're screwing it up. All right, this is it. This is my last life.
Last life.
Oh! My bunghole. He got me right in my sphincter.
Don't like it.
Okay, so what secret am I missing?
What? Boom!
And that's there if I screw it up. Perfect. Okay, so that's better. Right, that's better.
Boy. Right, okay. Okay. Right,
there's nothing over there, so we'll just go over here.
Hey, why didn't it let me do anything? What was that?
It wouldn't let me off. That's crazy. Old technology, eh? What do you do? Well, that was pretty good, but I don't know if we can beat that.
I don't know, man. Let's try.
I'm gonna go back to the chat line, see if anybody's chatting, see if Schlifty's still talking. Schlifty says the Game Gear version had different levels than this one. That wouldn't surprise me that they would try and redo it. That wouldn't surprise me one little bit. That's hilarious. And like I said, we've been doing insights like this on video games, getting deep and down, chatting, figuring things out, remembering the history, because we like reliving some of the amazing stories. Like, before we started doing Savage Sword of Conan on Tuesday, which premiered, right? We did the whole Anthem storyline from BioWare Games. Or no, not BioWare, Ubisoft. And that was the game that was... No. It was BioWare. Who did Anthem? No, that was BioWare. And unfortunately, like I said, that game was supposed to be the be-all and end-all of shooters as far as I was concerned. And it sure had the tools to do it. They just kind of shit the bed on the delivery, right? And Anthem never recovered. And we did a great 10-part series of that. That's now on the YouTube vault as well. It just, It's a sad, sad thing when you see these amazing games and stories that can and do amazing things. Like, look what Bungie has done with Destiny 2 and the Halo series. Like, what fan of video games doesn't know of those games? Like, they are epic in scale. Amazing, amazing stuff. And that's why this channel exists, to show a little extra light and a little extra love to the classics of old, creating our own animation series with a few extra. I got a few minutes, so let's go get some more of this Sonic action in before we call her quits. So we go see if we can find some extra hidden stuff. That's what we'll make this one about. We'll go find extra hidden stuff. God damn it! Oh, look at that trampoline! Screw that guy. Damn you, fish! Oh, there's something in the trees. What's that? Invincibility. Like it. I crush all these damn fish. Let's go back down. I saw something down here. Oh, it's just this goofy shit. Right. Good stuff, good stuff.
Boop. Poor little bunny.
Boom. Up. Oh, there's something up here. Look at this. What's this? Oh. I missed something. Let's go back and get it. Come on. Oh, I screwed it up. I saw something over there. There it is. Go find the secret. Secret! Secret! Ho ho ho! Look at all that shit. Is there anything in the trees? No. Shit! Get extra points, we give it a running start. Yeah! Look at that. Good times. Did we find any secrets? You let us know.
Oh.
Awesome. Good stuff.
What?
That goofy bastard.
Well, I remember. There's the shifty feet down there. We want to get that guy.
Actually, we want to clear these guys out, too.
Good stuff.
No, go back. Oh, you bastard. Wouldn't let me do.
Whoa!
How rad was that?
Rockin' and rollin'.
Maybe I wanna just goddamn them.
How cool is that?
Right. Definitely a lot of memorization in this game, wouldn't you say? A lot of memorization.
Oh, extra man.
No.
Jet!
Fun remembering the good old days, eh?
It's good to take time out for yourself once in a while. It's good to be successful, it's good to be busy, good to hustle. But you gotta learn to take care of yourself, too. Take a little time out, you know? Take a little extra new time.
Mental health is very... Where'd that guy come from?
Like, I literally never saw that dude.
Hey, gotta take care of yourself. Gotta take care of your mental health. Ain't nobody gonna do that for you. So be busy, live with intent. You gotta take care of yourself too, right?
So that just went up. That's a dumb thing.
Ugh. Whoop. Boom. Boom.
Thank you.
Well, you know what, fans? That's been a full 2 hours of this sucker. Been bumbling and stumbling through this old classic, remembering the good old times. It's been fun. But let's save our game in case we want to do this again, which I'm pretty sure we will. And I'm going to thank you one and all for checking us out on this awesome live stream. I didn't want Sonic to be too long. You know, a couple hours is good because, as you can see, this game's about pumping in the quarters and spending the time and memorizing and remembering where all this stuff is. This game is an old instant classic. It brings back a lot of fond, fond memories. So I'm very, very glad that you guys all got to check this out today on this fun little stream. Like I said, this channel is not all about blood and guts. It's not all mature content. I make something for a little bit of everyone, right? And throw in a little bit of Bob Ross wisdom and insights as well. You know, I'm not trying to be preachy or anything. I'm not telling anyone how to live their lives. I'm just, you know, sharing how I've lived my life, you know, without sharing too much, if that means anything. Remember that we're all human beings behind all these fun things that we're doing in our lives. We're all human beings, and we all got struggles, and we all got things we're doing that we love. And this is one of the things that we love. My family loves it. I love it. So we share our love with the fans of this channel. So don't be shy. Check us out next Thursday when we get into episode 2 of this pop culture icon trilogy, where we're going to get into Asterix and Obelix from the Double XL storyline from Atari Games. This is another old classic. Asterix and Obelix has been around a long time, but if you think they're big in the West, you should see them in Europe. Asterix and Obelix is a huge European hit, and rightfully so. I've been reading that since I was a wee little boy. Heck, screwing around with being a teenager, I was like wee little. So next week is going to be a whole lot of fun as we get into that cool, fun storyline. That's it for us. That's it for Total Nonstop Action Thursdays. I'm going to invite you to join us on our next stream, which is Epic Saturday Adventures, where we're currently in the Snapshot Games game of Phoenix Point. This is a tactical-based game, a lot like XCOM, right? And we are fighting a Pandoran virus infestation from the moon, and it's all over the planet. And so we're using our forces to try and help humanity rebuild after it's been devastated by this huge, huge virus. That'll be it. Have yourselves a wonderful time. Like I said, we got lots of different shows on Twitch right now. And all of our old stuff that we've been doing, like Guardians of the Galaxy and our wrestling events and our racing events, they're all on the YouTube vault. So go check us out. We've got some older stuff on there, like I said. Nowadays, we're filming in 1080p and 40 frames per second, which is pretty solid stuff. But when we started out, we was only in 720p and a little bit less resolution. So as we're getting better and as we're learning, our quality is getting better. And pretty soon, we're going to get so damn good that nobody can ignore us. Pretty soon. And when we spend enough time and money into the project, I tell you, everyone's going to know about it, because this is only part of the parcel that Rock Entertainment Media is getting into. Rock TV Presents, this gaming channel, is just the beginning and the tip of the iceberg. There is lots of things we got planned to have a lot of fun with this culture, the gaming world. Thank you so much for checking us out on this amazing, amazing episode. This is Rock TV Presents and Rage of Crixus signing off on another really fun podcast. Schlifty and everyone else that was joining us on the views and chats, thanks for checking us out. Have yourselves a wonderful time. Remember, if you like this stuff, like, follow, and subscribe, and follow all the links we got on Twitch. Thank you all again. Bye for now.